three nights, we have been quoting the sworn declaration of a former executive for ZXE, the former a company formerly called Blackwater, in which that executive describes a nearly global enterprise shot through with criminality, arms dealing, fraud, tax evasion, child prostitution, murder, all of which Z denies, even in cases where its employees have already pleaded guilty. One motive for all this, the four-year executive claims, was greed. Tonight, in our third story, the other motive was God. Jeremy Scahill, who first broke this story for The Nation magazine, wrote the definitive book on Blackwater in which he details some of the theocratic connections of founder Eric Prince. Now that former Blackwater executive, known only as John Doe No. 2, claims that Prince did more than subscribe to a fundamentalist Christian ideology. He used Z to advance it. Quote, Mr. Prince is motivated to engage in misconduct by two factors. First, he views himself as a Christian crusader tasked with eliminating Muslims and the Islamic faith from the globe. To that end, Mr. Prince intentionally deployed to Iraq certain men who shared his vision of Christian supremacy, knowing and wanting these men to take every available opportunity to murder Iraqis. Many of these men used call signs based on the Knights of the Templar, the warriors who fought the Crusades. As a young man, Eric Prince was an intern for the first President Bush and for the Family Research Council, the right-wing religious organization his father helped to start. He later complained about his White House internship. Quote, I saw a lot of things I did not agree with. Homosexual groups being invited in, the budget agreement, the Clean Air Act. A Catholic convert, Prince has donated more than $250,000 to conservative Republican politicians, primarily the religious ones. He has used the wealth of his family and profits from Z to create and to fund numerous right-wing and or proselytizing Christian organizations, the Family Research Council, Christian Freedom International, and the Council on National Policy, whose meetings Prince said he has attended. That last group, the CNP, was founded by this man, the Reverend Tim LaHaye, whose Left Behind series dramatizes his biblical beliefs that in the near future, Solomon's temple in Israel will be rebuilt. Jesus then returns, making true believers vanish away with him. Those left behind who accept Jesus battle the unbelievers. Mr. Prince's devout family values Christianity does not always manifest itself, however, in his behavior. After a Z, then Blackwater plane went down in Afghanistan, Prince argued that legal immunity pertained because companies cannot be sued for the actions of their employees under prevailing Afghanistan law, specifically the Islamic law of Sharia. Prince was interviewed by Suzanne Simons for a new book about him, a book that reports Prince cheated on his first wife, his dying first wife, with their nanny. Simons writes that the nanny attended the funeral while pregnant with Prince's child. Prince did, in his words, the right thing. He married the nanny. At Z, Prince has surrounded himself with like-minded believers, like the lobbyist Paul Behrens, board member of Christian Freedom International, and General Counsel COO Joseph Schmitz. As Inspector General at the Pentagon, Mr. Schmitz incorporated the phrase, always under the protection of the Almighty, into the official seal and said, quote, we pride ourselves on our strict adherence to the rule of law under God. He spoke to the Order of Malta, a secretive Catholic group at the Church of Paul Bremer, another conservative Catholic in the Bush administration, and Schmitz essentially exonerated U.S. General William Boykin for turning his mission missionary. After even Republicans slammed Schmitz for shielding the White House from congressional scrutiny of Pentagon purchasing, Schmitz resigned and went to Blackwater. Schmitz not only spoke to the Order of Malta, he is a member. Scahill reports the order is, quote, a Christian militia formed in the 11th century before the First Crusades with the mission of defending territories that the Crusaders had conquered from the Muslims, territories familiar to theocratic minds.
This crusade, this war on terrorism is going to take a while.
The Pentagon put Bible verses on its reports for Mr. Bush. Some of his soldiers spoke openly about distributing Bibles in Iraq and Afghanistan, spreading the word. Eric Prince once described Z employees this way. Quote, everybody carries guns, just like Jeremiah rebuilding the temple in Israel, a sword in one hand, a trowel in the other. The temple that must be rebuilt for Jesus to return. Bush officials helped Prince advance his vision. State Department Inspector General Alvin Krongard killed a probe into Z's weapon smuggling, then denied to Congress that his brother was on Z's advisory board.
I specifically asked him, I do not believe it is true that he is a member of the advisory board. During the break, I did contact my brother. I reached him at home. He is not at the hotel, but I learned that he had been at the advisory board meeting yesterday. I had not been aware of that, and I want to state on the record right now that I hereby recuse myself from any matters having to do with Blackwater.
Coalition Chief Paul Bremer, another Council for National Policy veteran, once said, I cannot succeed in this mission without the help of God, but he also needed Blackwater. He gave Prince his first big contract in Iraq. Bremer later wrote the Bremer Order, granting contractors in Iraq total legal immunity, and Z would need it. Quoting John Doe number 2 sworn declaration, Mr. Prince operated his companies in a manner that encouraged and rewarded the destruction of Iraqi life. For example, Mr. Prince's executives would openly speak about going over to lay Hajis out on cardboard. Going to Iraq to shoot and kill Iraqis was viewed as a sport or a game. A man whom Z called a disgruntled former employee put it this way.
Troubling when a group of Americans who are supposedly there to help in the rebuilding of a country consider those people to be less than they are, less human than they are.
But is there any evidence that these attitudes reached the battlefield? We've told you that Prince sent his men illegal ammo engineered to detonate on contact with human flesh. Out of three State Department security contractors, Z fired first in its shootouts, more than any other, firing first or being the only side to fire, in 84% of shooting incidents. July 1st, 2007, Z shooters allegedly open up on a minibus taking three families to the airport, dead, one nine-year-old boy, his father, his uncle, his mother, trying to shield her three-month-old daughter. The baby is also dead, shot in the face. February 7, 2007, Z snipers kill three Iraqi government security guards. Iraqi officials confront the shooters, who then joke about it. The State Department defends Z without, according to the Washington Post reporting, interviewing witnesses nor examining the scene. Christmas Eve 2006, a drunken Blackwater employee kills an Iraqi vice president's bodyguard. CNN reports the State Department kept this out of the killer's personnel records. February 16, 2005, Z sprays an Iraqi car with more than 70 bullets, presumably killing the driver. The Z security detail is codenamed Templar 20. The State Department determined Z lied about being fired on, but punishes nobody. Quote, any disciplinary actions would be deemed as lowering the morale of contractors. Out of 195 shootings from 2005 to 2007, Z was fired upon first just 32 times. Z has denied wrongdoing and will reply in court to the allegations, the legal allegations against it, later this month. Today, a judge ruled on Z's request for a gag order. Gag order denied.